Nigeria,
take it
back. If you believe in Nigeria,
take it back.
If you believe in Nigeria,
take it back.
If you believe in Sowore,
take it
back. Nigeria people.
Take your seats, please.
If you're not protocol, please, can you be seated? Yes. Thank you very much. Again, my name is Adeyinka Abinijagede, aka Don Babake. I am the convener together with a team of dedicated volunteers. Come together to push up this London Town Hall meeting. Please, I want you, in your esteemed self, put a round of applause to these people. Please, I want you to give them a round of applause. I can't explain the main names now, but they are from our country proud. Having said that, I want to say good afternoon, everyone. My president in waiting, Comrade Omoyele Sowore, gentlemen and women of the press present, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. The most common way people give up their power is by thinking they don't have any. And that is being said by Alistair Walker. As we are all gathered here in London from all around the United Kingdom for an exquisite town hall meeting to meet minds and chat to one another about our beloved country, Nigeria, it is my utmost pleasure as a convener of this occasion to welcome every one of us. We are the Take It Back movement in the United Kingdom, caught on with this wind of passion for genuine change, and that is not the sort of change that ABC promised us in 2015. Far from it, which began with friends of Nigeria in Nigeria and friends of Nigeria in the United States in collaboration with our ever passionate human rights activist, Comrade Omoyele Sowore. As we engage one another today on how young, able, and ever rested Nigerians are now ready to collect what has been stolen from them by the establishment of a handful of elitist Nigerians that has continually been shadowed by former military personnel, we want to appeal to every Nigerian young and old to democratically take their country back by using the power inherent in their voters' card, commonly referred to as BBC. To vote out incompetent leaders from power and install people of integrity and vision into the reins of power come February 2019. As Chris Brogan, an American author and journalist, once said, "Don't settle. Don't finish crappy books. If you don't like the menu, leave the restaurant. If you are not in the right path, get out of it." I hope that we all understand that.
Yes.
Basically, we are not on the right path in Nigeria. We need to get out of it. There has to be a shift, a paradigm shift from the stupidity that our leaders, our old guards are put up into. We need to start charting a new course for ourselves, basically. Today, I ask, what can be more instructive than these words? As I declare open the London Town Hall meeting, I leave you with these words by our one and only Nobel laureate in Africa, Professor Wole Soyinka. Thus, looking at the faces of people in Nigeria, one gets the feeling that there is a lot of work to be done. The professor has spoken. Yes, he has spoken. Mm-hmm. But it is our duty, your duty, my duty, to take action and do the work. Please let us all join hands together, especially our ever zealous youth, the ever zealous youth of Nigeria, to do this work. Thank you and welcome. And with that, I call on the moderator of this, Rose Graham, who is going to announce the grand final and dream of our presidential aspirant. Please put your hands together for Rose Graham.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Rose Graham. Will I say it was lost on the occasion? Because I visualize and we say we're going to say some really wonderful words. Embellish this young man who has taken it upon himself. He stood up, took a bold step, and wants to redeem both of us.
Yes.
Or redeem the entire community.
Yes!
He has boldly traveled to Nigeria, left his comfort zone. He traveled to Kano. From Sokoto Abound, I would say Kano to Kaduna. Benue to Bayelsa, Port Harcourt to Ibadan. Fearlessly. Letting everybody know that I'm here and I'm ready to serve.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a right to take our future back. To say to everyone, Nigeria belongs to every one of us. Not to a particular tribe. Not to a particular cabals or elites, or to the bourgeoisies like they put it.
Yes, sir.
For him to rise like this, I think we all owe it to ourselves to stand behind him. We're talking about over 40 million youths in Nigeria. If each and every one of us would decide to stand beside behind this young man, who is preaching nothing but transparency, his confidence, his tenacious, he's a good listener. That is what a good leadership is about, which we have lacked for years. We are living in a developed environment or country today. We see how things are done. We want it back home. That is why we're all gathered here. It's a burning desire which we all have to pursue. And he has decided to take this step. We have no other choice, ladies and gentlemen, but to stand by him.
I have chosen to stand by him. Not only
I would want us all, officially, the cameras are on, to rise up as we give a resounding ovation to the next president.
If you can have that place to us. Is he ready?
Our guest has played a role in landmark events
in Nigeria, such as aiding the constitutional transfer of power during the Yar'Adua presidency, and he was particularly instrumental in helping to provide a level playing field for the opposition movement in the change agenda in 2015. Omoyele Sowore is a human rights and pro-democracy campaigner, a campaigner for good governance in Nigeria and across Africa. He catapulted to national prominence between 1992 and 1994, when he led the Students' Union Government of the University of Lagos as their president. I'm sure I do not need to remind you all here how oppressive the military dictatorship in Nigeria was then. The Nigerian military government did not tolerate any voice of dissent, and Mr. Omoyele Sowore's voice was no exception to their ruthless quest to quench the opposition. Our indomitable guest has stared the tiger and the lion of Nigerian injustice in the eye, eyeball to eyeball. In 1993, he led over 2,000 students to protest against the military government's annulment of the June 20 election, during which he was arrested, he was interrogated, and was beaten up.
Sure.
During the 1998 Nigerian University Games, Nuga Games, the ceremony held in the University of Lagos, and Mike Adigwe, the then Chief of General Staff and Vice President of Nigeria, then was giving a speech. And our guest here walked up on stage and took the mic off him.
I was there.
That's the fearlessness of the man we are gathered here for today. That's the courage he has. He is not intimidated. And yes, he was arrested. He was detained. And he spent 2 weeks, I think it was Pantin, and as well as the Student Union President, you know that President Asatel. This man has continued doggedly with his fight against corrupt leadership, both within and outside Nigeria. When I say he does not know fear, he does not know fear. And many examples are bound to prove just that. You must have seen a video on YouTube, and that the video I'm talking about is the one of 2012, where he led members of the Occupy Nigeria New York team to disrupt a town hall meeting organized by the then former Minister of State for Foreign Affairs. That meeting had specifically to justify the increase in price of fuel in Nigeria. And guess what Sowore and his team did? They successfully disrupted that meeting.
Yes, I was there.
Yes.
They made the voice of the masses of Nigeria here on what stage? He has been arrested, he has been detained by both military regimes, the Nigerian police force, and the security services in Nigeria, countless times. And you will know that they have also plotted against him.
Of course.
Continue, some APC. Just continue.
Back.
Following the vicious attack on him, on his life, he relocated to the United States of America. And when he earned the Masters of Art degree in English Literature. But the dogged spirit within him can never be silenced. And so the struggle continues. Omoyele Sowore knows the price one pays for being anti-establishment. When you challenge the power, status quo, and he has done that several times. He has paid that price by sacrificing his freedom. He has lost dear friends. He has lost comrades in the struggle to hold our leaders accountable. But he continues to bear the burden of struggle to take back. To know Omoyele Sowore is to know his brand of fire and freedom. His undying passion for fairness, justice and equity. Of his long history of struggle for the masses. of his numerous incarcerations and his challenges, as well as the successes which have made his name. And whatever he is part of, so he's synonymous with the fight against corruption, with the fight against dictatorship, against injustice, and for the development of the evil, they say, triumphs when good men do nothing. On why they should raise a good man who has stepped forward to do something for Nigeria. Fellow Nigerians, ladies and gentlemen, in a round of ovation, I want us to give a big welcome to the UK, the forebearer of the Take It Back campaign, a passionate human rights and democracy activist, one with a long history of successes and challenges as well, one who has never turned his back on the fundamental struggle of taking back Nigeria from corrupt and decadent leaders and making Nigeria a better place for our youth and for our children. It's indomitable, indefatigable, and more emotional. And let's give him a round of applause. We are organized for the morning. I'll tell you. We all gathered here for the morning class, and I'll say to you, the man we're gathered here for is the king of it. Now we're going to move to the. It's going to be a talk session for some of our guest speakers to sort of discuss some issues. And after that, we'll be having the man himself from our initial regular to very short speech. And we'll proceed shortly after that to a question and answer session. So I'm going to make someone, Ayo Ogunleye, to please introduce and call to the stage the speakers who will be presented for 10 minutes each week. Thank you very much. Ayo.
It's not good. Everyone. Exactly.
Thank you. Freedom come home, my people!
Freedom! Freedom.